Good morning and welcome to Levy Park On Demand. My name is Lindsay and I'll be leading you through family story time and craft today. Today we'll be reading The Princess and the Pea, illustrated by Dubravka Kolinovic. Once upon a time, there was a lonely prince. He lived in a big castle with beautiful rooms and a pretty garden. But he wasn't happy because he didn't have someone special to share them with. If only I could find a lovely princess to marry, sighed the prince. The king and queen did their best to help. They held balls so the prince could meet princesses from all the nearby kingdoms. The prince danced with tall princesses and small princesses. He talked to loud princesses and proud princesses. He met all kinds of princesses, but none of them was quite right. After a while, the king and queen ran out of princesses for their son to meet. Maybe it's time you went looking for a bride, suggested the queen. So the prince packed a bag, saddled his horse, and waved goodbye to the king and queen. Good luck, said the king. Come back soon. The prince traveled far and wide and searched high and low for the princess of his dreams. Along the way, he met lots of lovely princesses. Princess Grace loved to dance, but her twirling made the prince dizzy. Princess Ginger loved to cook, but her cakes made the prince chubby. Princess Flora loved to smell as pretty as a flower, but her perfume made the prince sneezy. Achoo! Maybe I'm just too fussy, thought the prince, but in his heart he knew he hadn't met the princess of his dreams, so he headed back to the castle. When he got home, the king and queen greeted the prince happily. I haven't found a princess yet, he sniffed sadly. I guess I never will. Don't be silly, said the queen. The right girl will come along soon. That night, there was a terrible storm. Thunder boomed so loudly that it rattled the castle's windows. Rattle-tattle! Lightning shook the table as the prince and his parents sat down to eat their dinner. The prince was about to help himself to dinner when suddenly they all heard a loud rat-a-tat-tat. Someone was knocking on the front door. Who could be visiting us on a night like this? Asked the queen. The prince opened the door and found a very wet girl standing there. Raindrops ran down her muddy cloak, making a puddle at her feet. Drip, drop, drip, drop. The girl pushed back her hood and wild curls tumbled out. Hello, she said with a smile. I got lost on my way home and wondered if I could stay here for the night. My name is Princess Polly. She didn't look much like a princess, but the princess must always be polite, so he invited her inside. Soon the princess was warm and dry. All night long, rain fell clippity-plop, clippity-plop on the castle roof. But the prince hardly noticed because he was too busy talking to Princess Polly. She was pretty and funny and kind. Princess Polly was everything the prince had hoped to find in a princess. By the end of the evening, the prince had fallen in love. But the queen wanted to be sure that the girl was really a princess. The queen told the servants to pile them high with mattresses. They heaved one on top of another until they had no more mattresses left. Then they placed a pillow and quilt right at the top. Underneath the mattress at the very bottom, the queen placed a teeny tiny pea. Only a real princess would be able to feel something so small through all the mattresses. When the queen showed Princess Polly to her bedroom, the girl gazed up at the tower mattresses but didn't say anything. She was just grateful to have a bed for the evening. Good night, said Princess Polly. Sleep tight, whispered the queen. Then the Princess Polly changed into her nightgown and climbed right to the top of the pile of mattresses and snuggled under the quilts. The next morning, Princess Polly came down to breakfast with dark circles under her eyes. She let out a great big yawn. How did you sleep, my dear? Asked the queen. Princess Polly burst into tears. I'm afraid I couldn't sleep a wink. There was something lumpy and bumpy in my bed. It kept me awake all night long. To Princess Polly's surprise, the queen clapped her hands with delight. So she is a real princess, the queen cried. The prince was overjoyed. Will you marry me, Princess Polly? He asked. Yes, squealed the princess, and they live happily ever after. The end. Thanks for tuning in for The Princess and the Pea. Today we're going to be making a princess or a prince craft. The supplies that you're going to need is a paper plate, or you could use a piece of construction paper that you cut into a circle or even some cardstock. You're going to need some markers or some colored pencils or some crayons, some pom poms, or you could even use marshmallows, you could use cotton balls, or even some buttons, some scissors, and some tape. All right. So to go ahead and get started, what we're first going to do is we're first going to decorate our crown. So for my crown, I'm going to put some fun swirlies, and I'm using some of my favorite colors, which are pink, green, purple, blue, and orange. So I'm going to do some swirlies and some stars, and probably some dots too, like the sample that's over here. But you could draw a picture on yours. You could add fun stuff to yours if you wanted. You could even add some buttons just to the crown itself. So I've got my crown in the way that I'm going to be decorating it here. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut, I actually have two plates, into the crown. So in order to do that, what we're going to do is we are going to fold it in half, just like that. And then we're going to cut a straight line out to the edge here. And you're going to go almost to the edge there, but not quite. And then you're going to cut right in half of that. Almost to the edge again, but not quite. And then you're gonna cut a third slit on the opposite side. Almost to the edge, but not quite. So then you have your crown here. The next thing you wanna do is kinda just fold up those edges so that your crown points stick up. Just like that. There you go. And then the last thing that we're going to do is we're just going to tape on our little pom-poms, or buttons if you have them, or beads, or marshmallows, whatever you decide to use as your little crown points. We're going to attach those just to the top there. And I like a lot of colors, so my crown points have all different color pom-poms. But if you have one particular color that you love, feel free to just use that one color. So you're more than welcome to use any kind of tape here. I'm actually using some double-sided tape because I found it makes it a little bit easier to stick the pom-pom on. But if you don't have that, you can use glue or just some regular tape. Pause. Start. And I've got my last pom-pom. Here. Alright, and now you've got, I just got some together, a cute little crown for you to wear. I'm not a kid, so it's a little bit tiny for my head. But if you used a regular sized plate, it would fit on an adult and a small plate for a tiny child. So. Thanks so much for joining in today. Be sure to like, comment, or share our video below if you'd like to know more about how you can donate to Levy Park Free Programming or get our full calendar list of all the Levy Park On Demand programming that we offer. Visit levyparkhouston.org.